Hi, I'm Robin Worley. Welcome to Lenscraft. Today I want to share 6 landscape photo editing tips for Lightroom that could improve your photography. Not all the tips are specific to Lightroom. You could also apply many of them to other RAW editors. The first tip applies to any photo editing, which is to start with a clear idea of the finished image. If you don't, it's very difficult to go from something that might look terrible to something good. Ansel Adams always talked about the importance of pre-visualizing the finished photo before taking the shot. The same advice also applies to photo editing in Lightroom. Ansel also had a very clear vision and worked to a plan when developing prints in the darkroom. If one of the greatest ever landscape photographers went to this effort, so should you. Many people start their photo editing by moving the sliders around to see what they like. When they hit on something that catches their attention, they move on to the next adjustment slider. There's no problem with experimenting, but you need to keep the finished image in mind and work towards it. If you don't, you end up with a set of random adjustments and an image that probably leaves you disappointed or underwhelmed. The second tip is don't touch the saturation slider. Saturation is one of the first sliders inexperienced photographers increase because raw images often lack saturation. Please don't make this mistake. What often happens is that after increasing the saturation, they make contrast and color corrections, which pumps up the saturation further. Because these changes happen gradually, they don't realize the image is becoming oversaturated. The result is an unnatural looking image, which isn't what we want when editing landscape photos. Leave the saturation and vibrance sliders alone until you've finished making your image adjustments. Tip number 3 is about camera profiles. Don't settle for the default Adobe Color profile. Lightroom uses camera profiles to convert the data from the RAW file into the colors and tones in the image. Most people have Lightroom set to default to the Adobe Color profile. This is a good all-round profile for editing, but unfortunately, it's not the best for landscape photo editing. But you can easily change to another profile in Lightroom using the profile browser. Many other RAW converters also have a similar feature. Here you'll find several Adobe profiles which are available for the RAW files for any camera. Then below this section, you'll find the camera matching profiles. These profiles are specific to your make and model of camera. When you move your mouse pointer over the thumbnail, the main preview shows the effect of that profile. You may find one of these is a better starting point than the default Adobe Color profile. Personally, I try to avoid profiles with a lot of saturation and contrast as a starting point. I find that it's better to control this in editing using the Lightroom controls. This RAW file that I'm editing came from a Panasonic G9, and the camera standard profile works well with most images. If you think about your camera settings for a moment, you probably have a profile set there as well, even if it's the standard default. It's possible to change Lightroom to respect those camera profile settings rather than automatically applying Adobe Color. In the Lightroom preferences, select the preset tab. There you can change the global dropdown from Adobe Default to Camera Settings. You can even configure Lightroom to override the settings for specific cameras rather than all cameras using this option. Now to tip 4, which is to have a standard checklist of adjustments before you start editing. This is going to include things like spotting to remove dust spots, lens corrections, leveling the horizon, and applying any calibration adjustments, like increasing the blue channel saturation, which some cameras respond well to. You could even save some of these as a preset to save time. If you think back to the previous tip, you could even apply them automatically using the settings in the Lightroom preferences. Alternatively, you could apply them as part of the Lightroom import process if they're saved as a preset. Tip 5 is to minimize early adjustments with the basic panel controls. It's extremely easy to overcorrect landscape photos using these tools. The problem is that these are global adjustments and affect the entire image, but many landscapes need localized adjustments. Using the global adjustments, you can affect areas of the image in ways that you don't want to without even realizing it. In this shot, the sky is too light and the sea has a strong shadow. I could use the basic sliders to adjust this, but the image wouldn't look quite as natural and convincing at the end of the editing. As an example, my adjustment to darken the sky could affect the light reflecting off the sea. Instead, I'm going to use the basic panel sliders to correct the big problems that affect the entire image. I'll increase the temp slider to warm the image because it's a little on the cool side. I'll also increase the exposure to 0.6 to lighten the image. Despite the sky being too light, the overall image is a little underexposed. It's then only after making my other changes that I'll return to the basic panel if I need to. This is the opposite of how I used to work, but the results are better given Lightroom's new and improved editing tools. Which brings me on to tip number 6, which is the most important. The key to better landscape photo editing in Lightroom are the local adjustment tools. With this image, the imbalance of exposure between the sky and sea makes it difficult to move towards my vision of the finished photo. Usually I like to start with the biggest problems, which are the most obvious. This probably means working with the graduated and radial filters first, after which I'll start to use the adjustment brush. I'll start by adding a graduated filter to the sky and use this to reduce the exposure by 0.2. Then I'll reduce the highlights to -70 to make the clouds clearer and more intense. Another useful adjustment to improve the sky in landscape photos is a small increase in the dehaze adjustment. With this image, a setting of 15 works well to emphasize the clouds. The lightest parts of the clouds are now looking a little bit dull though, so I'll increase the white slider to around 15. This helps to bring some of the brightness back. Next, I'll use a second graduated filter to select the sea. I want to use this to lighten the midtones in the sea and bring out the reflected light. To lighten the sea, I'll increase the exposure by 0.2. I'll also increase the highlights and whites by 40 to emphasize the surface light. After that, I can see the light on the water looks a little cool. I can correct this by moving the temp slider to +15. I can also see the darkest parts of the image are becoming too light. This is like the global adjustment problem I mentioned earlier when using the basic panel. To avoid this happening though, I'm going to protect the darkest areas of the water using the luminance range mask. Rather than trying to watch the mask, I'll just move the black point slider to the right until the sea looks good. With the large problems fixed, I can close the graduated filter and switch to using the adjustment brush. For this example, I'm going to use the Lightroom Dodge preset with the adjustment brush set to a flow of 50%. I can work with the brush now to paint in the areas I want to highlight on the sea. But rather than trying to do all my dodging in a single selection, I'm going to add a new mask for different areas. A second mask allows me to add highlights to another area at different strength. Overall, I'm happy with the image tones, but the blue saturation I set earlier in the calibration panel is looking too strong. I'll reduce that from 50 to 20, and I'll also try the red channel saturation. An adjustment of +20 seems to improve the warmth of the sunset without making the blue in the sky too strong. I'm now satisfied with the Lightroom adjustments and would probably continue to refine the image further using Photoshop. If I compare the adjustments I've made in Lightroom to the original, you can see that it's made a large improvement, but without lots of global adjustments. I hope that you find at least some of these tips helpful in improving your photography. They may not seem exciting, but they can help you avoid some of the common pitfalls when editing landscape photos. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.